So Afrobeats royalty Femi Kuti and Made Kuti dropped a dual release Legacy Plus album. Here's my review.
1, 2, 3, 4.
What up, beautiful people, it's your boy Mano, aka Power and Papi. Welcome back again to the channel. Today we are looking at Afrobeat Dynasty, man. Femi Kuti and Made Kuti releasing a dual album, Legacy Plus, alright? So it's two albums, essentially, but a dual release, basically released at the same time together and packaged into one. So from Femi Kuti, we are having an album called Stop the Hate, and from Made, his debut album, Forward. Okay, obviously with the last name like Kuti, you already know what they're about. Afrobeats, very raw, very authentic, coming from that blend of Ghanaian high life with juju, with funk and jazzy influences tied with political and social commentary. It's an album that definitely ties into the ideals and principles of Fela Kuti. Now for Femi Kuti, he's an absolute legend in his own right. Well, no matter the achievements that he tends to attain for himself, and it's kind of a blessing and a curse, because everyone is gonna see him as Fela's son. And he has really, really like been instrumental in terms of like pushing Afrobeat sound. And I think he was very instrumental in bringing more jazzy elements to Afrobeat, especially with his gifted skills on the saxophone. I think that's his element. And you can see that very well present on this album. He didn't push back at all in terms of showing us his skills on the saxophone. Funny fact is, he actually has a Guinness World Record for holding the longest notes on the saxophone. Now, Femi kicked off his career being a member of Fela's band, and much like him with his father, same way with his son, man, Made was a member of his band, and now Made is coming out and rolling out as an artist. So it's very wholesome to see how full circle everything has come. Which brings me to Made, as he proudly carries the torch of Afrobeats on this album. He studied in Trinity Laban Conservatoire, and he performs every instrument on this particular album. And it's amazing to witness. Now, in terms of the flow of the album, it made sense for Femi to come first, and it really helped solidify the evolution of Afrobeat sonically, and even in terms of the message as well. Femi was unapologetic about his messages, about his stance on political issues. Right from the first song, Kwa Kwa Kwa, which means very, very quickly in Yoruba, he starts the album on a very, very high note. And it was very brilliant to see how the high tempo kind of symbolized the message of urgency that is needed from a government. Now, funk being one of the major elements in Afrobeat was very, very evident in this song, Kwa Kwa Kwa. Right from the very famous James Brown catchphrase, Get Down, down to his vocal inflections.
Get down, come on, get down.
Another favorite song of mine was As We Struggle Every Day. This was one of the leading singles to the album. I like the song for a lot of reasons. I think it captures a lot of what Femi Kuti tried to do on this album. Like I mentioned, a lot of this album captures the ideals and principles that Fela had used in Afrobeat, such as call and response, the speak singing kind of cadence that they have over the instrumentations, very, very repetitive lines to really, really emphasize a message. And the core message of this song was to address the masses to stop rewarding mediocrity from the government and rise up to recognize its own power by keeping leaders accountable. Now, in many instances, this very same message can be interpreted as condescending and insulting to the masses, but somehow Femi finds a tone to deliver the message in such a way that it can be received respectfully. And the fact that he's pointing out that, hey, we have our own power, we should enforce and tap into our own abilities. In general, Femi Kuti's Stop the Hate album ended up being very much more conservative in terms of maintaining the ideals of Afrobeats, the principles that Afrobeats music is being made from. It ended up being cohesively very high tempo, electric, in your face. It really grabs you at the first listen. I'm very, very unapologetic about its messaging against corruption. I think the core of Stop the Hate was essentially corruption. Which leads me now to Made Kuti's album, a much more progressive take on Afrobeats. Much like his father's album, it touches on political commentary for a while, but he opens up the album by looking at self instead. He's looking at, let me open the mind of my listener first off before we explore the range of topics that we're about to get right into. So it opens it with Free Your Mind. Much like the tempo from Stop the Hate, it actually helped transition us into the B-side of this album, the forward-thinking side of this album. Another song worth pointing out as well is Your Enemy. It's a brilliant song because the title of the song is like a double entendre in a way, because the song talks about police brutality. But we already know that statement, that police is your friend. But in this case, it's calling it your enemy, and it's recognizing the fact that there is police brutality, and it's also pointing us to the root cause of it, because it's saying, and this song is saying, policeman, much like myself, is in a depressing state, much like everyone else is in the country. And for policemen to be depressed and with guns and authority, it only makes sense that they will take advantage of that authority to oppress the masses. And it's pointing us to the real enemy, in this case, the real enemy being the ruling class that has oppressed the rest of the masses. So it makes sense. And I thought it was a brilliant play of words for the song title, Your Enemy. And you can tell that the recent events in NSAR is definitely inspired and motivated a lot of the content and messaging that Made Kuti went with on this album. Now, the song Blood takes us on a journey of post-colonial Africa, post-colonial Nigeria in this context, and it talks about the excitement about how everyone was in the early days of our independence, and how from all of that hope in that moment, and how we've transitioned into what we are today. And it tells the journey. It tells of where did this go wrong? Like where did we lose the focus, and what essentially happened? And you can see the meat of the song being, the bulk of the song being an audio of Femi Kuti's speeches in Paris and in the Ojota protest, as Made mentioned on his Instagram live. Now, the song Different Streets was a moment that pointed out exactly what I was thinking, even just from the mere existence of Made's career. The mere existence of Made's career is almost a symbol in itself that many of the atrocities that people were going through in the times of Fela in the 70s are still the things that we are facing today. So we've seen little or no progress whatsoever. And the fact that Made is like the three generations down the line, and this the same messages are still being said on these songs. He pointed it in his monologue on this song that Fela wasn't a prophet. He wasn't foreseeing the future. He was just talking about his present. And it's crazy that his present is still our present. On this song, Higher, you find was unfortunately one of my least favorite moments on this one. It served as an antidepressant for the album. No, don't get me wrong. It was a very uplifting spirit, because I'm like all the topics, all the range of topics can be downers. Okay, can definitely bring down your spirit. But this particular song was meant to be a more celebratory moment. Like, content-wise, though, or messaging-wise, I don't think there was much here being said. Very, very repetitive with the statements. But I think the bulk of it here was the instrumentation. Like I said, he performs every instrument on this album. So you can see him almost be playful on here with almost every instrument. Now, with the song Him, it's about children. You can hear children actually singing on the song. On this song, he tries to turn our focus to the future of society and looking at children as a focal point for that. But on the flip side of things, sonically, I don't think this was a very strong moment in terms of instrumentation from this. I think it was a very dull moment, but nonetheless, he never misses on his messaging, and this was a very strong point of that too, pointing out the vulnerability that children still have in society of today, and how important they are as well, and acknowledging the role that they play for our future. It was a very, very nice tone of the album. It helped change the energies on the album a little bit to hear more innocent voices, more, you know what I mean? There's just certain joy that comes with hearing children singing, and I felt that. Now, the song Young Lady is another range of topic that I love to see. I love that he is exploring beyond just a political standpoint. It's tackling a lot more societal issues. And this song, Young Lady, talks about the misogyny. Like, can a woman be allowed to grow, let her thrive, rather than setting up more hurdles in front of her? And it was a nice touch as well for the album. It was a nice touch when it comes to variation of topics. And it was one angle I definitely appreciated from him as well. And the last track, it almost feels like a call to action for us to all come together and move as a unit. And definitely ties back to the protest as well, to see that we were definitely stronger together. And I think that was the overall message that he was trying to pass across for the entire album. So it was a journey of its own, and it made sense. And for his first debut album, I absolutely applaud his effort here. And being on every instrument on this album, tackling different difficult topics. You could see the progress that he was trying to bring into this. His take on Afrobeats is definitely much more progressive, a lot more risk-taking, a lot more abstract, a lot more psychedelic, especially with the help of his very baritone-esque voice, you know. And even as progressive as he is on his range of topics, you can see him tie back to the ideals and heritage of Afrobeats, where he uses like almost a lengthy session to have a monologue on. I feel like those kind of, we're just little odes to Fela's legacy and the way he transmitted his message. It was a very sweet introduction into his career. Obviously it's called the foreword, so and when you're reading the book, it's a foreword for his story, for his journey, and it made sense for a debut album. Overall, man, Legacy Plus, dope concepts to have his father and son release a body of work together. And like I said, in general, Femi Kuti, you can see him very, very much more conservative approach here in terms of the Afrobeat sonics, even on the subject matter of the album, tying very closely to politics and calling out corruption, whereas Made came in here with a much more progressive, a much more challenging approach for him to make a statement for himself, for him to have his own sense of identity, because that's one thing that kind of can easily be lost once you have a last name like Kuti. Everyone's gonna see you in one box. And now that he tries to grow as an artist and find his own voice, find his own range of opinions, you can see him already display that on his debut album. And it's very commendable to see that already from the first jump. Overall, great album. My final rating for this would be 8.2. With that being said, thank you so much for watching. If you're new to the channel, go by the name of Emmanuel, aka Power My Papi. Definitely check out the rest of the content. I have more videos coming up shortly. I'm just trying to roll out all these reviews as quickly as I can, so definitely bear with your boy. And thank you so much for watching again. I'll see you guys in the next one. Peace. As we struggle every day.